Hi, have you ever seen how the feedback circuit actually works? We know that two types of feedback are often used in switching power supply. In this device, voltage and current feedback is reported to the IC through special resistance. These values are reported as voltage to the IC. So, how much is this voltage? Let's check together. This is a switching power supply with 12 volt output. The output current is 10 amps. This multimeter is connected to the output of the device with the help of these two wires. The black probe of this multimeter is connected to the negative output connector. I use this multimeter to measure pin number 1 of the IC. But before measuring the IC voltage, it is better to check the circuit schematic. This is the schematic of the 12 volt switching power supply circuit. The IC used is TL494. There are two op-amps in this IC. The voltage feedback is directly connected to pin number 1 of the IC through these two resistors and this resistor and this potentiometer. The op-amps calculates the difference between the two input pins and provides the appropriate output. Op-amps also react to very low voltages. There are two op-amps. The first op-amp is for voltage feedback, and the second op-amp is for current feedback. We focus on voltage feedback, so we will check the voltage of pin 1 of the IC. If there is a change in the output voltage of the device, no voltage change should occur in pin 1 of the IC. If there is a voltage change, the output of the op-amp will change according to the voltage on the input pins. Therefore, the voltage that reaches pin 1 of the IC must always be accurate. This voltage is compared with the voltage on pin 2 and the corresponding output appears. The output of these op-amps is placed on pin 3 or the compensator. Well, before I continue the video, I want to introduce a unique company that is the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. This company offers you a variety of services, including manufacturing and preparing PCB and CNC machines, 3D printing, and services that we all will need one day. Well, let's go back to the subject of the video. The output of the device is 12 volts. I select pin 1 of the IC. The voltage of pin 1 is about 2.541 volts. I choose pin 2 of the IC. The voltage of pin 2 is about 2.539 volts. The voltage of pin 2 is slightly lower than pin 1. Now, with the help of this potentiometer, I change the voltage of pin 1. We want to check whether changing the voltage of pin 1 changes the output or not. We know that the voltage of pin 1 and pin 2 should be accurate. The IC changes the output in very short time, like microseconds. I choose pin 1. About 2.541 volts. Now, I will change this potentiometer. Pay attention to the output voltage in the multimeter on the left. I increase the voltage. About 14 volts. Pay attention that the voltage of pin 1 changes very little. I reduce the output voltage again. Look at the multimeter on the left. Now the voltage is about 10.81 volts. The voltage value remains constant. In the multimeter on the right, I increase the voltage again to 12 volts. Pin 1 voltage remains constant. So, by receiving the voltage from the feedback circuit and comparing it in pin 1 and 2, the IC changes the duty cycle so that we always have an accurate voltage at the output. Thank you for watching the video.